Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you a chill out the whole block. My baby, Nicole, hear ye her.
Thank you, Dad. That was quite an introduction. It's a lot of pressure. Well, before I get started, I just want to thank all of you for allowing me to come here as we celebrate your dreams. Every year, we come together to honor a man who had a dream. A dream that would help us, you and I, love who we are. This man, Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., who we all know and we all recognize, said that he had a dream that one day his children would not be judged by the color of their skin, but by the content of their character. And I'm here to tell you, young people, that having good character, being a nice person, doing good things for others, helping others, respecting others, and being honest, those are things that are the keys to help you achieve your dreams. When I was a little girl, my dad, who you just met, he used to tell me every day before school, he would drive me to school, and when he dropped me off, he would say, remember whose child you are and whose child you represent. Now that's a lot of pressure. I didn't know what that meant back then. But as I stand here before you today, I know exactly what he was trying to teach me. He wanted me to know that when you're out here doing things in the world, when you're out here and you're making decisions and choices, you don't just represent yourself, young people. You represent your family who love you and who support you. You represent God who took the time just to create you. Now, I know you all know this movie. It's one of my favorite movies. It's called The Lion King. It's been out for a while. And one of my favorite scenes in this movie is where Simba sees his father's reflection in the water pool. And his father is telling him and talking to him about coming back home to Pride Rock to take his rightful place as king. Now, a king is a leader, young people. It's a great responsibility. And a king is someone who has the power to influence and the power to direct other people's lives. All of you have that same power. You in this room, there are future kings in this room. There are future leaders in this room. For my young sisters here today, there are future queens in this room. You have the power to do great things, and you have the power to be great leaders. Now the question is, how are you going to do that? What are some things that you're going to do to make sure that that happens? What are some things that you can do to make sure that you step up, rise up, and take your place as future kings, queens, and leaders of this world? There are four things that you can do. One, you gotta practice your talents. We've seen a lot of that here tonight. We've seen violinists, we've seen dancers. You gotta practice your talents. Everybody has a talent. Everybody has something that they are good at. You gotta figure out what you are good at, and you gotta do those things to the best of your ability. You gotta do those things as often as you can. If you like playing basketball and you're good at it, tell mom and daddy or whoever you live with, take it to the rec center so you can practice dribbling that ball, practice shooting that ball. Because that's the way that you get better. There's always room for improvement. Always room for improvement. If you can win at Monopoly, I can't, but if you can. You like being the banker? Young people, let me tell you something. One day, you can own a bank and make some real money. And I'll say that to you again. You can own a bank and make some real money. Whatever your talents are, whatever things as much as you can. Because that's the way, again, that's the way for improvement. And that's the way that you get better and better. Number two, you gotta be unlimited. Like a cell phone plan. It's good to have your options open, you know, have a lot of coverage. You gotta not limit yourselves and not limit your dreams. In your life, you're gonna have many dreams. And it's okay to have many dreams. No one understands that. It's good to have many dreams. Don't limit yourself. You can do whatever it is that you want to do. Don't let anybody ever tell you that you can't be whatever it is that you want to be. You want to be a lawyer, a doctor, a teacher, a preacher. You want to be a police officer, an entertainer, an athlete. You can do it. Because God has given you the power. And with God's help and through Jesus Christ, you can do all things through Him. And I'm going to say that again. With God's help, through Jesus Christ, you can do all things because it is He that gives you strength. Nothing is impossible with God. The third thing that you can do is you got to do your best under the circumstances. Do your best. Put forth your best effort. Whatever you do should be done to the best of your ability. When you're in school or when you're at home doing homework, do the best you can. And if you need help, don't be afraid to go to your parents. Don't be afraid to go to your grandparents. Don't be afraid to go to your teachers because they're there to help you. They care about you, they love you, and they want you to do well. So do your best. Put your best foot forward. Give it your best shot because that's what's needed for you to take your place as kings and queens. And the fourth thing, and finally, but it's last on my list, but it actually should be the first. I talk a lot about God, and this is about trusting God. Young people, you have got to trust God. God has a plan for each of your lives. My favorite scripture in the Bible is Jeremiah 29:11. And that simply says, "For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans to prosper you, not to harm you. Plans to give you a hope and a future." God wants you to be happy. He wants you to be successful. And if you put your trust in Him and you believe with all of your heart that He has your back, He will give you everything you need. Everything you need to achieve your dreams. Cause there's no mountain too great. I hear these words and have faith. Oh, oh, oh. Mamela, have faith. Mela, oh, Mela, Mela. Hey, let's sing you. God's best. Thank you.